Lucky Philip Dube was born on August 3, 1964 in Ermelo in the eastern Transvaal region in South Africa. His parents separated before his birth and he was raised by his mother Sarah, who named him because she considered his birth fortunate after a number of failed pregnancies. Along with his two siblings, Tandy and Patrick, Dube spent much of his childhood with his grandmother. While his mother relocated to work in 1999, in an interview, Lucky Dube described his grandmother as his greatest love. He said she made him what he is today. As a child, Dube worked as a gardener, but realizing that he wasn't earning enough to feed his family, he began to attend school. There he joined a choir and with some friends formed his first musical band called the Skyway Band. While at school, he discovered the Rastafari movement. At the age of 18, Dube joined his cousin's band, the Love Brothers, playing Zulu pop music known as Umbankanga. The band signed with Teal Record. The first album was named Lucky Dube and the Super Soul. Lucky Dube drew inspiration from Jimmy Cliff and Peter Tosh. He felt the social-political messages associated with Jamaican reggae were relevant to a South African audience in an institutionally racist society. He decided to try his new musical genre in 1984. He released his first album, Rastas Never Die. The record sold poorly, around 4,000 units, in comparison to the 30,000 units his Umbankanga records would sell. Keen to suppress anti-apartheid activism, the apartheid regime banned the album in 1985. Lucky's second reggae album, Think About the Children, attained platinum sales status and established him as a popular reggae artist. Lucky Dube won several awards, such as Best Selling African Recording Artist, International Artist of the Year, 4 OK TV Music Awards, and his next 3 albums won major South African awards. South Africa is plagued with crime. It is also stated that South Africa ranks number 1 for murders per capita and 2nd for assaults and rapes in the world. On October 18, 2007, Lucky Dube was killed in the Johannesburg suburb of Rustenburg, shortly after dropping 2 of his 7 children off at their uncle's house. Police reports suggest he was shot dead by carjackers. Thousands of people gathered to attend the privately held funeral service for Lucky Dube. People came from all around the world to sympathize with one of the continent's greatest artists. There can be no one like Lucky, and I know we all gonna miss him. Lucky, we love you, and may God bless you.
I recorded the first song, the first reggae song in this room here, this very place here. And the engineer and the producer would like listen carefully to what you're saying. And then they would stop the tape and say, no, you can't say that. And I said, why? No, you can't say that. Because one, the record won't be played on the radio, and 2, the government won't be happy, and, you know, it will get into trouble and all of that. as a child when I was very, very young that I want to be a musician and music is what I will do, you know, for a living and like for the rest of my life. Well, the messages in my music come from, you know, when I was a child, things that I have seen happening to me and happening to people within, like the South African apartheid system. So the mission, one mission I had in life was to say, okay, if I do get a chance to be able to speak about these things and let people know about these things, because they, you know, to us, as a child, growing up in Emelo, which is Emelo has, I mean, it's still got a lot of apartheid going on now. And to us, it was just life. It was just part of life. To us, that was what life is all about. And knowing, I remember the shops, they used to have one door for blacks and a little window there for black people. And if you made a mistake and got in that door, you get your ass kicked and all of that, you know. And I mean, these are the things that I have experienced, and these are the things that I write my songs about now. And really, my childhood is what makes my song. The experience I had as a child is what I sing about today. Two white boys wanted to know, you know, they had two dogs, like these mean, heavy dogs. They had those dogs, and so they wanted to know which dog is, like, wow, the heaviest, you know, the one that can bite the best or whatever. And so there was nowhere else, you know, where they could test these dogs, but they had to find a black man to do that on. And unfortunately, I was the black man at that time, just walking down the street. I was from school. And they stood there with the dogs, and as I came, they called me. Fine, I could not say no if the claim bus calls me. And I had to go to the claim bus. And they let these dogs loose on me. I was working as a gardener before I even started school, for like white people in the white suburbs. And one day they called me from the garden, and they used to call me Fanyan. Because my name, Lucky, was English, and they didn't like English. And the other name, my other name is Philip, and so they wouldn't call me Philip because it's an English thing. They didn't even, maybe, they couldn't even speak English, maybe, so they called me Fanyan. And they called me, Fanyan, yes, boss. And I came up, and there was like, all of them, the mother, the father, and the three children, and their two friends. And as I came up, I thought, there must be something wrong here. Why are they all here? Why are they all coming to me, you know? And they got to me and said they had some machine that I didn't understand, but it had two wires hanging, a red and a black. And they wanted me to hold the wires, those wires. And I held them, and there was this boy, this claim bus, started turning this thing, and it was producing like a 220 voltage thing, and it kicked the shit out of me. And that was his new toy that his father bought him. And so to know how it works and how much it can kick, they had to test it on a black man. And unfortunately, at that time, again, it was me. The black man around was me. But all of that was like life to us. That was what life was all about, because you couldn't do anything about it. You couldn't tell anybody about it. Person, I'm a human being. God did not create Africa, America, and this and this and this. God just created the world and God created people in the world. And then people came and said, this is South Africa, America, that and that and that. That's just a continuation of separating people, you know. So I am just a human being, you know. It's like people would ask me if I'm a Zulu or a Swazi or whatever. I'm not that. I'm not a Zulu. I'm not a Swazi. I'm a human being. God did not make Swazis. God did not make Khoisas or Zulus.
A happy childhood, as I look at it now. But at that time, I mean, I knew nothing better.
Yeah.
You know, that was what I was getting, and I thought, well, that's what life is all about. But
the song Slave was released around about 1987. And in the video, we just wanted to show people what liquor does to people, because I have been a victim of that. We know that a lot of families have broken up because of liquor, and it was a very big problem, especially in the black community.
Yeah.
That was a song that talked about the people, the freedom fighters, people that were in jails, people that have died, people that were still fighting for freedom. It was basically a song about the freedom fighters.
Freedom fighter, standing on a mountain in a foreign country, trying to send a message to his people back in the ghetto. He had a home one time, love of a girl, but he left all that behind. Oh yes, I can hear it clearly as he whispers.
When I did this video, Prisoner, I nearly got shot by the police. We were doing the video in Soweto somewhere, and it was during the time when Soweto was a bit scary. There were a lot of guns and things going on there. And so, as you will see in the video, I've got a gun with me. And I had this gun, and there was this police van that was passing by, and they didn't know that there's a video being shot, and they thought I'm some criminal with a gun at a shopping center or something, and they came for me, and the director had to come and go, no, it's a video camera, you know, things like that. And they nearly shot me, you know. But I really enjoyed doing that video, because there was this part where I was dragged by horses and things like that. And I enjoyed doing that because I love making movies.
Somebody told me about it when I was still a little boy. He said to me, crime does not pay. Education.
policeman said to me, son, they won't build no schools anymore. All they build will be prison, prison. They won't build no schools anymore. All they build will be prison, prison. They won't build no schools anymore. All they build will be prison, prison. Cause today, prison, prison, all the bill will be.
Now that I found you, baby, I ain't gonna look no further.
because Lucky Dube is about togetherness, and the music is about togetherness too. And so I was trying in this song to get people in South Africa together, and I think that was the first song that was allowed on the SABC with the word apartheid in it, because any song that had something apartheid, they wouldn't play.
In my whole life, my whole life, I've got a dream. My whole life, my whole life, I've got a dream. Too many people hate apartheid. Why do you like it? Too many people hate apartheid.
Singing this song, the whole world should be singing. politicians never separate the people. Government.